We're delighted to present RT-1, Robotics Transformer for Real-World Control at Scale. This is a joint work between robotics at Google and everyday robots. In the past few years, we have seen powerful machine learning models that achieve significant generalization capabilities by absorbing large amounts of data. Importantly, these often called foundation models have the ability to effectively absorb large amounts of diverse data. In the case of large language models, that data is text, which allows them to discover patterns and generalize between the observed data points. We have seen a similar trend in computer vision, where models that can absorb large amounts of image data can exhibit really impressive generalization capabilities and describe or generate images at an unprecedented level. Our goal with this work was to see if we can build a similar data absorbent model for robotics, a model that will get better with diverse data and improve its generalization capabilities along the way. To accomplish that, we have collected a large data set of real-world robotic experiences that consists of over 130,000 episodes, more than 700 tasks, and was collected with a fleet of 13 robots over 17 months. To absorb all of this data, we present a new model called RT-1, or Robotics Transformer, a simple and scalable action generation model for real-world robotics tasks. RT-1 scales with data and shows strong performance across hundreds of tasks. It also presents extensive generalization abilities and robustness in real-world settings. This is how our model works. We take a language instruction and a set of images from the robot's camera as inputs and pass them through an ImageNet pre-trained EfficientNet model that outputs a set of tokens describing the task-relevant parts of the image. The EfficientNet is also modified to condition on language using identity-initialized film layers for early fusion of language and image. We then pass the tokens via Token Learner, which outputs a compressed set of image tokens, resulting in over 2.4x inference speedup. Finally, these tokens go through a decoder-only transformer that outputs discretized action tokens corresponding to arm and base target poses. The resulting RT-1 model can successfully execute over 700 text instructions in the real world and generalize to new tasks, objects, and environments. We compare RT-1 to other baselines of similar size, showcasing its superior performance and generalization capabilities. RT-1 is better on seen tasks, on unseen tasks where the skill and objects were seen separately but combined in novel ways, and on scenarios with distractors and background changes. Next, we decided to push the absorption capabilities of RT-1 even further by mixing the original data with data from a different source. We want to test if RT-1 can show two properties that are desirable for a general robot learning model. First, that its performance on the original task doesn't deteriorate when a new data source is brought in, and second, that the new and different data boost generalization. In the first experiment, we train RT-1 on original data mixed with simulation data. This data was collected in simulation by transforming unseen objects with a cycle Gantt to look more realistic. We observe that the resulting performance doesn't drop on the original task, but at the same time, it significantly improves for objects observed only in simulation. This shows that RT-1 is able to successfully absorb simulation data and use it for better generalization. In the second experiment, we extend the data absorption capabilities of RT-1 using grasping data autonomously collected on a very different robot, a fixed-base KUKA arm used for a project called QtOpt. If you train only on KUKA episodes, it doesn't work at all because it is a completely different robot. However, when we mix data from both robots during training, we observe that RT-1 is able to infer the actions of the everyday robot's robot when faced with the states observed by KUKA without explicit demonstrations of pin picking. Performance on the original task doesn't drop either, yet generalization capabilities significantly improve. This presents an exciting avenue for future work where we combine many more multi-robot datasets to enhance robot capabilities. Given the high performance and generalization capabilities of RT-1, we also test on long horizon realistic robotic tasks in real kitchens. To do that, we use Seikan that breaks down a long horizon task expressed in natural language into a sequence of low-level skills. Here we see RT-1 executing tasks in three different real kitchens, two of which it has never seen before. The first instruction is bring me the rice chips from the drawer. We see that manipulation tasks require multiple handoffs between navigation and manipulation. So manipulation policy robustness to variations in initial conditions such as base position is essential. Here, we can see RT-1 attempt retries despite initial failure. The second task is roses are red, violets are blue, bring me the chips from the drawer and a napkin too. In this task, the manipulation policy needs to handle articulated objects and deformable objects, which would be difficult for traditional model-based approaches. We can see RT-1 successfully manipulating the drawer and pulling the napkin from the napkin dispenser. Here, we see RT-1 attempting an ultra-long horizon task, which is bring me all the graspable objects from the counter. Long horizon task success fails exponentially with task length, so high manipulation success is particularly important for this. As we explore future directions for this work, we hope to scale the number of robot skills faster by developing methods that allow non-experts to train the robot with directed data collection and model prompting. We are also open sourcing the code for RT-1 and hope that it will provide the research community with the valuable research for future work on scaling up robot learning. To learn more, check out the original paper and the project website at robotics transformer.github.io.